Hello? Anyone about? Have I got the right place?
Oh, brilliant. Here we are. Hello, Nedley. I see you. Can you hear me?
Hello, Winnie. It's lovely to see you.
What's that?
I said it's lovely to see you.
Nedley, I think your sound's off. Can't hear you at all.
I said it's lovely to see you.
Try one more time.
I can't believe I'm having technical difficulties when I finally get the chance to spend time with the girl I have a crush.
Just kidding. Your mic is working just fine.
Oh, nice weather we're having.
I wouldn't know. My mom and dad won't let me outside until this whole thing blows over.
My parents are the same.
Are we early? Where is everyone else?
I don't know.
I see Malco's screen, but I don't see Malco.
Can you believe we have to take classes online? How will that work?
I know, right? How are we supposed to practice the magical arts of wizardry on a computer? I mean, who can do that?
I can, that's who.
Malco, where did you come from?
I used an invisibility spell, that's what I did.
You were hiding under your desk, weren't you?
A wizard never reveals his secrets. I'm so glad that we don't have to be stuck in that stupid dog wars. And now I can just stay home in my palace with my mumsy and dadsy and my loyal servant who treats me like the prince I am.
Would Master Malco like to have another pixie pastry?
Not now, Snobby, you stupid house elf. Professor Snoke will be here any minute.
He hasn't shown up yet.
I see Plotter isn't here either. That fool probably doesn't even own a computer. I hear he lives in a closet under the stairs.
Poor Harry.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor Harry Plotter, the boy who lived. More like the boy who whined.
That's not very nice.
Why are you still wearing your uniform?
I thought we were supposed to.
You're so nerdy, Nebly.
I'm not wearing all of it.
Wait, what? Are you wearing just the top?
Well, yeah.
Are you naked from the waist down?
No.
Are you sitting around in your underwear?
No. I'm just wearing my jammies.
Jammies?
I mean, my pajama bottoms. My PJs. My overnight leisure wear.
I think that's sweet, Nebby. You don't have to be embarrassed.
Thank you.
Let's see them.
What? No!
Then at least tell me, do these pajamas of yours have a design?
Yes, but I'd rather not say.
I bet they're covered in teddy bears.
No, it's Thomas the Tank Engine.
Professor Snow!
There will be no wand waving or silly emojis in my virtual classroom. Nor do I have any tolerance for hashtags, tweeting, Snapchats, or selfies. As such, I do not expect most of you to appreciate the subtle art of PowerPoint. However, for the select few with a tech-savvy predisposition, I can...
Professor?
What's wrong with Snoke?
I think his screen is frozen.
Someone cast a frozen spell?
Can you hear us, Professor?
Oh well, a good time for a snack. Snobby! Where's that house elf when I need him?
So how long do you think we'll have to stay like this?
I hope it doesn't last. I mean, being in magic class, and eating in the magic cafeteria, and going to all the magic dances.
Which reminds me. I wanted to ask you. If we go back to magic school, maybe you and I could...
I can teach you to download files, upload images, and carry on conversations from the comfort of your own home. Where's Malco?
I'm right here.
Behold, my students. I appear before you on this Muggle telly, here to teach you the always delicate and sometimes deadly art of magical potions. Yes, it would be nice if we could all be back in my delightful dungeon of a classroom. However, thanks to the Chimera virus, we are forced to wizard in place for the time being. So, let's make the most of it, shall we?
Professor Snow, how long until they reopen magic school?
I don't know.
Will they cancel magic prom?
I don't know.
Professor Snow, is it true that the virus began from Muggles eating unicorns?
No, that's not true.
My dad says it.
Well, he's wrong. That's just one of many rumors I've dispelled on my website.
Snopes.com?
Precisely. Now, shall we take roll? I see we have our Weasley little Mr. Nebley, our always prim and proper know-it-all, Ms. Winifred, our slightly off-center Ms. Moona, and our ever-changing Mr. Nerville, and our resident snob-slash-bully, Mr. Malco. But where is our new celebrity, Mr. Plotter? Absent again, as usual.
Oh, sorry to be late again, everyone.
What, dare I ask, happened this time?
Well, I was about to confront the Dark Lord in the mystical Forest of Doom when the Death Eater sent a troll after me. So I had to travel back in time on a flying hippogriff to save the Goblet of Fire from a giant snake.
It is always something with you.
And then my friends and I rode on a dragon.
I don't care. Your tardiness will cost House Rippenroar 15 points.
How many points do we have now?
-352.
No worries. I can make that up by the end of the term. I always do.
Mr. Plotter, your confidence is matched only by your ineptitude.
Sorry if my screen is a bit blurry. I'm here in my closet under the stairs. Did I tell you I live in a little old closet under the stairs?
Yes, several times.
It's very cramped, and my aunt and uncle are terribly mean to me.
Ah, Vatica, don't care. Now, let's begin today's lesson. Write down the following list of ingredients. 1, root of pure wood. 2 drops of glistening Malco. Why are you not writing this down?
Sorry, Professor. I can't seem to find my quill. Do you have one I could borrow?
I do, but how do you plan to obtain it?
Oh, I almost remember.
Don't hurt yourself, Malco. Allow me. Wingardia Luzeroso.
Ooh, magic.
Yes, Malco, magic. What you should have been learning for the last 4 years.
Professor Snope? I'm afraid I'm having trouble finding my quill as well. I think it should be one in one of these coat pockets somewhere.
Well, by all means, why don't we just stop the class altogether until Mr. Plotter searches every blasted jacket in Little Muggle Closet?
It's actually not that little, sir. In fact, it seems to go back an awfully long ways.
Plotter, get back here.
There's a lamppost back here. And A forest covered in snow!
Plotter, you fool, that's Narnia.
And I see a man with goat legs beckoning me.
Plotter. Fine. Anyone else going to pop through some mystical portal? Or may we continue with today's lesson?
Hello, students.
Hello, Principal Bumblebore.
Hello, Principal Bumblebore.
Oh, Professor Snoop, I hope I'm not intruding.
Actually, you are. I was just about to go through.
I just wanted to tell everyone that we will all get through this calamity. Unless, of course, we don't.
Very comforting, sir.
Principal Bumblebore, was the virus started by someone eating a unicorn?
Oh, most definitely.
No!
Sir, if I may, will there be a magic prom this year?
Oh, who can say? It's not as though I have a crystal ball. Oh, wait, I do. It's here somewhere.
Sir, perhaps we could do this another time?
Oh, yes, of course. You get back to potions, and I'm about to get back into my new in-home exercise routine. We must stay fit in both mind and body. Hey, Snoop?
Yes, sir.
Goodbye, students.
Goodbye, Principal Bumblebore.
Goodbye, Principal Bumblebore.
And now I just press the off button. There. What delightful students.
Sir, your screen is still on?
That Professor Snoop, though, what a wet blanket.
Sir, we can still hear you.
I wonder when young Nebley will finally get the courage to ask Miss Winnie out on a date.
Nebley?
I don't know why he would say that.
Well, time to do my exercises.
We can still see you, sir.
But first, I better remove this cumbersome robe.
No!
No! Make it stop!
Avada Kedavra!
Oh, thank goodness.
Now, can we get to today's lesson without any further disruption?
Where am I? What year is it?
Plotter, where have you been?
I've been in Narnia for the last 40 years, and I became king, and I fought the White Witch and saved a big talking lion!
We don't care. Now, you will all please shut up. Here is today's potion. The most important one you may ever create.
Is it an invisibility potion?
No.
Because I already know how to do that.
Is it a fire-breathing potion?
No, that's Sriracha.
Is it a love potion? Not that I would be interested.
Oh, Natalie, you don't need that sort of potion.
Quiet. Today's potion is a muggle recipe. It's called homemade hand sanitizer. Now, the first and most important step, and it's vital that you pay attention to this, you must always remember to...
Oh no.
For the love of Snobby! What are you doing? Put down the sock, Snobby! Put down the sock!
Professor Snow, he's frozen again.
I wish I were frozen again. I miss the winters of Narnia. I have to go back!
No, you don't, Harry.
Yes, I do! I'm the chosen one!
Wow. Virtual classrooms, am I right?
Yes, quite. Nedley?
Yes?
I got the impression there's something you wanted to ask me.
What? Oh, nothing.
Oh, I had thought, well, never mind.
I had wanted to ask you something, but it seems everything has been turned upside down.
Oh, I have a counterspell for that.
No, I mean, things have changed.
You mean the school closing?
Yes. Truth be told, Benny, I had been meaning to muster up the courage to ask you to go with me to Magic Prom.
Well, it shouldn't take that much courage, you silly lad. I would have said yes.
You would? Really?
Of course. I've been wondering when you were finally going to get around to asking me.
Oh, that's smashing. I mean, well, it would have been. Would have been lovely to go to the dance with you. Too bad we can't.
Who says you can't? We're not going to let some confounded unicorn virus spoil our fun. Let's have a virtual prom.
But how?
Why, all we need is a little bit of magic, a little bit of music, and a whole lot of funky dance moves.
Best virtual prom ever. Don't
believe me, just watch. Danny, that's the funny stuff to see. I think I love.
And that's how you create hand sanitizer.